Yeah, when we first got married, we have just like anybody else. It's a happy day of your life. You got together with that person you want to be with the rest of your life.
She was a strong Christian woman, and she fought for what she believed in the church and in our family as well. She was the glue to our family.
Every day she dropped me off at school. Doesn't matter if we're in bad terms. She'll always say, you know, school first. She always told me to have a good day and that she loved me. And I never skipped a day of her telling me that.
The thing that makes me smile when I think about her is her smile. Always remembering, you know, her, the way she talks to us, you know, inspiring us to keep pulling forward and, you know, just keeping it real with us, you know. That's one thing I can say that makes me smile. My mother is very loving and caring for a lot of people, and she was the key to our family. She held our family together. She more of an organizer to our family, and she was also very straight out.
She was always there for me, no matter what. Even though I was a pain in her butt, but she'd always make it to whatever event I was participating in, she'd be there for me. When I'm sick, she's always there, making me laugh or staying up with me until the next day.
She always takes time out to come by or swing by physically to be there, to see what's going on and to listen to what you have to say. Even if she isn't feeling well, you know, her priorities are towards others instead of herself. You know?
She was a lot of fun. She was always trying to make fun out of something. She light up the room. I mean, everybody could just have like the boringest time or something, but something about it when she brings a lot of joy and laughter, making everybody laugh. But she was something special, you know, all from someone, from the little kids all the way to the senior citizens of the family, from the church to friends around her. She touched everybody. She touched everybody because how special she was.
I miss her. She's not present anymore. Miss her laugh, her jokes. Miss our little conversations. I didn't come down without her. But the life is still there. Even though she's not there, I can always feel it. Her comfort surrounds me when I'm in her house, through her husband and through her children. But I miss my friend, my weekend friend, when I come down. And she's truly missed.
Our conversations always ended with, "Love you, sis." I always end it with love. He says, I'll talk to you later. I could sit around the house and all of a sudden the phone would ring. It'd be Helen. And she'd go, how are you doing, John? I'm fine, you know, and then we just start conversing about anything and everything. And, you know, Helen will always be in our hearts. She'll always be a part of us. But she's a part of her kids, as well as Eli. And, you know, her mom, you guys were her life. You were her life. Everything she did for you, for a better life.
My sister Helen was an angel. That she was the most beautiful person I ever knew. Someone who was always organized, someone who was always in charge of what she did. And she took charge of everything that she put her mind to. As we grew up, I learned to love my sister Helen a lot because of who she was and what she meant to me. She was a sister that I could call anytime I wanted and to speak on little things and small things and big things and just things in general. You know, she always reminded me to take care of myself and to take care of the things I needed to do. And I always thought about the same thing about her. You know, I guess the most important thing I miss about my sister is that she's not here to talk to anymore. And that, I just want her to know that I love her.
My favorite thing about her, whatever we don't we agree on it, and then we do it as a family. The smile. We always crack jokes and stuff like that. And I miss, you know, most of the time, I miss somebody yelling, you know, in the house. Not only the kids and me too, but that's how that person is. That's how Helen is. Even though she's gone, but I miss my wife so much. Love her out of my heart.
You showed me right from my wrong. that you did, and you took up for me when everyone was down on me. You always did understand. You gave me strength to go on.
You know, every day I do miss her. Just try not to think about it. But it's always gonna be there. Yep. It's always gonna be there. Mom. I just love you. Wish you were here with us. And, I know you're watching the worst right now. Keeping us strong. Keeping us going. Something that makes her smile, seeing her kids accomplish anything, maybe the smallest thing to, you know, to actually, you know, finishing their school, you know. One thing my mom told me that made her smile was my dancing, when I was dancing with Tupamon. She said that was one of my best choices of, you know, of doing anything, you know, doing that, you know, that should make her really smile every time. I'll be dancing, I'll look for her in the back to where, you know, in the tables, where they're doing the raffles or, you know, the tickets. You know, that just helped me more.
Her jokes, her always trying to get into the new hip ways of all the youngins. Her always trying to learn the new dances and telling us that their old school dances are just being recycled. She starts getting up and starts dancing. It tells us that we get our moves from her. You know, she used to try to say she used to dance Tahiti. I'm like, I don't know, Mom. She was always humble. And that's what I really do appreciate and love about her and what I learned from her. So always be humble. I just miss her a lot. But I know that she's still with us. I feel her presence every day.
I love and miss her very much. And I think I had the best 25 years of my life was with her. And just wishing that I had 25 more years with her right now. But things, they say things happen for a reason, and we gotta keep pushing through. And I know she's in a better place, but her spirit lives within us. So us as kids, we gotta push on forward, that she lives within us, and we gotta make her proud here and within our family, and just keep pushing for better and bigger things, and just taking on what the teachers she's taught us with. And just move forward from here, and knowing that she'll always be missed.
Still in the fact that our family here is also founded on God's love. For God is first, love among each other, being able to accept each other no matter what, being able to just have that humble heart, to be able to forgive one another, whatever may come across our family. But number one is always God first.
Remember, you know, food to my soul.